this video tutorial, one of many in a series designed to get you up and running with Leapfrog. This video is part 4 of 4 discussing basic geological model building. In the previous video, I demonstrated the new intrusion tool, and in this video, I will show the new deposit and new vein surfaces in action. The data set I'll use to show the deposit tool is the same as in the previous video, but in this case, I'll be using a different column of data. This means that I need to set up a new geological model, this time selecting the strat column of data. I will set the column extents and the resolution the same way I did last time. I'll give the model a name and click OK. The concept of building the intrusions from youngest to oldest remains, so we're going to begin by building the quartz porphyry and the granodiorite again. Again, I'm going to use a plane to create a simple trend for my quartz porphyry. Now that I've created the quartz porphyry, I will begin the granodiorite. I'll select the granodiorite as my interior lithology. And as we saw in the last video, the quartz porphyry is a younger intrusion and therefore wasn't around at the time of the emplacement of the granodiorite. So we don't wish to make contact points with that unit, and therefore we'll pull it into the ignored column. Again, if I'd like to create a trend for this granodiorite unit, I can view just the intervals within that unit, create a new plane for it, and set the trend. Now we can see that instead of having miscellaneous sediments surrounding the intrusions, there are units labeled D1 to D5. As these are simple depositional units, we can use the new deposit tool. Unlike intrusions, depositional units can be built either youngest to oldest or oldest to youngest. It doesn't really matter as long as you're consistent. In this case, I'll start with new deposit from base lithology. We can see we start by selecting the primary lithology and then deciding whether to use contacts above or contacts below. If we start with D1, we will of course need to use contacts below to contact the D2. Once I commit to using contacts below, I will use that for every subsequent deposit surface that I make. In this case, I already have contact points between the quartz porphyry and the D1 from when I built the quartz porphyry unit, so I'm going to ignore that. Now that I've created D1, I can take a look at it and then create the next surface. This time I'll select D2 as my primary lithology using contacts below. I already have contact points for granodiorite and quartz porphyry, so I'll drag those into the ignored column and click OK. I'm now making my final surface, which is going to be the contact between D4 and D5. As I mentioned in the previous video, you will always have one fewer surfaces than you have final volumes, because as we can see, that last surface defined both the D4 unit and the D5 unit. Now that I've created all the surfaces, I can once again define the surface chronology so that I can create the appropriate volumes. Again, I'm going to order my units from youngest to oldest, tick the box to activate them, and click OK. Leapfrog will turn the surfaces into the output volumes, and we can now turn our surfaces off so we can see the complete volumes of our geological model. Lastly, we'll take a quick look at the vein tool. For simple veins, it's easy to set them up. Simply right-click on the surface chronology, new vein, again from base lithology. All we need to do is select the unit of interest. In this case, I'm going to use the quartz porphyry as an example. Next, we need to decide whether or not we wish to use the points at the ends of the holes. What that means is if a hole ends in the vein unit or begins in the vein unit, will Leapfrog create a hanging wall or footwall point at that location? This can be changed at a later time, so you don't need to commit to it right now. You can see the vein itself was pretty simple to create. If you click the triangle beside the vein object in the project tree, you can see all the pieces that have gone into making up that vein. These include the separate hanging wall surface and footwall surface, as well as the actual hanging wall points and footwall points that Leapfrog used to create the surface. We can see them here in the red and blue. There are many tools that can be used to edit the vein. For more information about them, please see the Leapfrog blog and the Leapfrog help menu.